not in what's the school debate nowadays. And nothing, Mr. Mayor, has been done to deal with, as we've seen, Dunfermline, our roads and pavements are now about as clear as Hoy Lake Beach. Mr. Mayor, the only improvement we have seen to this council's finances over the last 12 months are the result of the proposals and the plans that have been passed by the Conservative Group, the Liberal Democrats, the Greens and the Independents. The Wirral view has been scrapped because of what we did, not because of what they did. £26 million, they're so hard up that they were going to find £26 million to give to their private sector developer on the Hoy Lake Golf Resort until the other group said no. And £29 million, as we've heard from the Audit and Risk Committee, £29 million of unauthorised spending in the first 6 months of the current financial year. And then, last but not least, the flawed plans in his budget last year to privatise the council's four golf courses on the back of a fag packet to such a degree that we had to throw those plans out as well, so that saving, as realistic as it was, wasn't achieved either. Mr. Mayor, and like Audit and Risk, at every meeting, we uncover yet another policy failure of the group opposite. Mr. Mayor, for the reason that I've outlined, the Conservative Group does not believe that the Council's budget, as submitted by the Cabinet, represents best value for the taxpayer of this borough, and nor does it deliver on the priorities that the Leader himself outlined 12 months ago.
Just has passed on the bill to help maintain our police services, to recruit officers. So hair bill will go up from £179 for my house to £188. The last year we heard about the mayoral precept, to be fair, the present mayor of Merseyside has kept it the same. So my balance is £16.89 for that body. I don't say services at that body. So and our fire service goes up from £70 in my house to £71, and I don't get a rich penny of it. And I'm sure members of the fire authority know just how much work there is to try and achieve that figure. So the overall effect, total council tax for my house, goes up from £16.20 to £16.84. And of course it varies by band. So I'm not going to go into all the other bands. So let's say that because we see things for that money, members of this council are anxious that our services are retained. But we know, precious, there's the one of children's budget, cost of capital children. And one of the things that really irks us, and we talked about it some months ago, is that the weekly rate for placements for children going to certain care places is now £3,389. And we said, and I hope Councillor Lewis has referred to it, the issue of getting a service for children that might involve working with other authorities on their side, and does it involve trying to find sites for homes? Because I have, I think some members have, what I call the scars on our back about finding a site for a home in Wirral many years ago. It happened to end up in Wirral. It was called Brookside. Yeah. The day before it opened, there were members of this council who were saying, right, we're going to get closed. In some respects, never had a chance, but it did close. Because whatever happened, and it's a problem of finding committed staff that can cope in those circumstances, and getting them trained, and that's why we need to look on a Merseyside basis. And the issue was dealt with at Children's Scrutiny Committee on the budget. I'm surprised that it's raised by Councillor Lewis in such different terms now, because if you look at that, Mr. Boyce, the director, said this is sensitive, we're working on it, we won't have proposals immediately, but we plan to do something. So there may be providers on the Merseyside that we go into partnership with because of that crisis. In terms of adult care, well, of course, I vice chair the adult care committee, and that's another area of considerable pressures. And I'm not going to detail all those, but in order to meet the needs of the Care Act, we've tried as an authority to look at what people's care needs are and meet them. But we have a budget challenge. If you look at the savings for this coming year, there's a contracts review supposed to find £4.5 million. A modernisation of the council structure supposed to find £5 million. This is work in progress. So again, in August 2018, I asked for a monthly report on how many interims we have and what their cost was. We did start getting and still have those monthly reports. And along with other members, we've looked at why have we got these people on high salaries and high day rates, and we've spent the year trying to drive it down. Reference was made by the leader to employment appointments tomorrow night. Yes. In Councillor Lewis's amendment, there's a criticism, like so, structure and the top costs. But we know since last November, members of that committee have asked the Chief Executive for reports on driving down that cost, and there are proposals coming tomorrow night. So it's rather, as I've said, no offence, cheeky to put an amendment in saying effectively nothing's being done about it when it is being clamped down on things that are being done about it and remain up the savings figure quoted by the leader. I'm not going to the figure because it may be exact. Yeah. And then we have the crisis in public health. We have a deadly crisis in public health at the moment, a national crisis in public health because of the virus. And we have, as authorities, been pressing for an answer, a confirmation of the public health grant for this year for some time. I'm happy to know whether it has been arrived or not. But it's a quarterly payment. We have to claim it. We spent £20-odd million on public health and put in particular key areas that are very cost effective. And as I recall it, £27.2 million in the public health grant this year, £6.3 million for internal functions, £2.4 million goes in environmental health, £0.7 million in housing, £2.3 million in leisure and various organisations. So we're trying to make the best use of it. Now, you'll see, I have actually got three men, so I love this, but there's small one. There's the big main one about the budget, but it accepts the budget. But our key theme in that is that we have to monitor it closely. There are things we can achieve. In our amendment, we've suggested, my colleagues will talk about later, energy efficiency, road safety, tackling housing, and the housing building requirements mentioned. I submitted today a motion for the next council about that. I have seen these proposals. We have sites, we need to look at sites, we need to get housing associations in line, we need to find out what's coming from Homes England, we need to do that deal with the city region and get building in order to get revenue from those homes and meet needs and get the right needs. Now, Mr. Mayor, schools have been touched on, and I have a moment about that, and the council officer has graciously said support what we're doing. As a governor for, oh dear, 40 years, I joined Birmingham Secondary School for Boys' Governing Body in 1975. I joined Robert Secondary School Governing Body in about 1981. Both those schools closed.
Bear with us for a moment.
Can you see if I'll double hands up, George?
6 to start it, so could everyone sit down then and we could ask you again.
Okay,
Councillor Jill Wood,
would you like to?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I was quite surprised really by the tone of Councillor Lewis, because having read through what was presented as an objection, kind of didn't play out the same way. So my initial notes that I did were based on what was in the actual objection. And I was surprised really, because I think that there's a level of delusion there. I think there's absolute partisan party politics going on there. I was going to say there's some sort of mendacious level going on, but maybe not. Councillor Lewis's tone was much different. But I come here today fully expecting to find that this whole of this chamber would vote through our budget. And it's a, you may well have. And a budget, well, our budget is a budget that continues to ensure that despite the theft, and it is theft of over 250 million from our funds, from the party that Councillor Lewis represents, our budget that ensures that the children in our care get the support that they deserve, that tries to ensure that the elderly and the elite get the services that they so desperately require, and ensures that the residents get the services that they rightly expect. But no, that's not what's going on here. Instead, the party opposite, yet again, trot out, and these are the words in the objection, they trot out the discredited fabrications of economic mismanagement dating back to over a decade of Tory governance, and that even their own ex-chancellor, George Osborne, has acknowledged was political posturing, a deliberate attempt to mislead in order to secure power. They seek to blame a Labour government that introduced your start, invested in the National Health Service, and took what every serious economist and academic and politician agree were the necessary steps to stop our economy imploding. Whilst many of the Tory cabinets were back then were profiteering from the casino capitalism that actually caused the financial chaos in the first place. So, when I move on and think back to the motion that was put forward, or the report, to say that they object, there was an attack there, an attack that seemed to be at our senior officers. These are the same officers that have been working magnificently with our colleagues in the NHS over the past few weeks to ensure that the people in quarantine have got the help and support that they need. To me, that was quite unforgivable given what's going on. But perhaps, Mr. Mayor, everybody on this side would like to ask Priti Patel for her tips on how they should deal with senior officers.
Any increase in above CPI but the rate at which wages are actually rising is unjustified and immoral. But Labour always believe that they know better on what to do with other people's money, with the public's money. Mr. Mayor, this budget comes to the backdrop of this Labour-run council managing to find £7 million of taxpayers' money for the View Cinema, which they intend raising to the ground. £5 million are going into a slush fund for the Wirral Growth Company. £400,000, which was wasted on an unwanted and disastrous Wirral View newspaper, which I'm proud to say I was pivotal in bringing to its sad end. Contractors being paid £900 a day and £2.3 million on a senior management team. Mr. Mayor, I too call for this cabinet budget recommendations to be rejected and the priorities set out in our proposal, along with a true corporate approach, which I've heard cabinet members talk so much about, to be taken up. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
It's not just about housing, although housing is is really important, and we see public housing decimated at the hands of Tory governments, past and present. It was Tory governments who began to take apart public housing, and they've continued ever since. And now we finally have the opportunity, and Councillor Hackett has made clear that we will be taking that opportunity to go forward and build more public housing. Because by building public housing and taking people out of housing poverty, we will reduce pressure on many of the services. The cost of housing poverty on our health services and on our social services and on our mental health services is immense. And so giving people decent, warm, quality homes will again reduce the pressures on all of our other services. We talk about, Councillor Lewis talks about, why haven't we done things about bringing our children's homes in-house so that we can better support our looked after children. If, as a result of austerity, we have had to cut so many services to early years, so many of our youth services, we wouldn't have as many children who need to be looked after as we have now. So, yes, we do understand the importance of having as many of our services in-house as possible, because contracting everything out to the private sector is not the way, despite the fact that it's the way of the party opposite, it's not the way of this party. And we see the value of our council services. And we know that as a result of this government's policies, there are homeless people who are dying on our streets. Even here on Wirral, we've seen this happen. People are using food banks in their thousands. Children are going to school hungry. And how on earth can they learn? Even if schools have a decent budget, how could they learn when they're hungry? That can't be done. So those are the things that I'm angry that we can't correct, because we simply don't have the funding. So,
could you just finish?
So I hope that people will see this objection for what it is. It's a mealy-mouthed piece of hypocrisy, and it's not a genuine objection. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Less future energy costs, also incorporating renewable energy.
condemn than cooperate. Searching for fault. I could go on, but I think the chamber gets it. In conclusion, behaviour clearly and unequivocally demonstrates the politics of the programme, with all the opposition playing the roles of the folk as petulant individuals. I just hope that I won't be the victim of retribution when school's out, but on the receiving end of a verbal attack. But as I said, it's just a hope. Thanks, Mr. Mayor.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so we ask people to stand off again if you want to take the time to be. So we'll take another six.
Told there's 40 in the end, I think we really need a dose of reality here. And I think what Ian has identified is there's a lack of ambition in this budget, and there's also a lack of grip in the way money is currently being spent. And if I may, in just 2 seconds, Mr. Mayor, say to Pat and Tom how much have I enjoyed serving on the club. I only recently heard that you're going to be stepping down, Pat. I think you tried to do an excellent job as leader of the council. Paul, but you've had a really good go. You've reached out to the whole of the council, which I appreciate. And Tom, thank you very much.
Yeah.
communities, unlike other communities where they found millions of pounds to support disaster-struck places like Salisbury and Wigan Bridge. This Labour Party and this Labour Cabinet have certainly